Hi folks, this is David Kwan here, and a couple of weeks ago, there was this cartoon, and it's in the video description below. I posted the link to this cartoon. It's a very powerful image, cartoon image, of kind of that paints the picture of what's been kind of happening with cases like Eric Garner, Michael Brown, a lot of cases in which unarmed black men ended up dead at the hands of because they interacted with the police and they were shot to death. In case of Eric Garner, he was choked to death. So this is a powerful image. And I actually, a couple of weeks ago, like when it was published, so this cartoon was published on December 3rd, Wednesday, in 2014. So December 3rd, 2014, this is when it was posted. And if you click on the, maybe you guys have already seen it, but this is like a picture with a whole bunch of tombstones at the front. At the back are some tombstones without a name, but just riddled with bullet holes. There are police officers kind of surrounding the cemetery area. There's a SWAT car, armored vehicle, and at the back is an armored vehicle too. And at the very back is this kind of van. That's kind of the news media van. And in the news media van, that there's a comment saying, "Quick to the ratings. To the riot." You know, so that's kind of interesting quip there. And there's also a convenience store that looks to be kind of in a very crumbling manner. I think a lot of stuff has been missing, so it kind of looks like it's been looted. You know, and there are kind of people in the area, but that's kind of the picture, and I thought it was a very powerful picture. And one of my good friends from high school commented on this one. You know, I'm not gonna really quote what he said, but he didn't have he had an interesting reaction to it. You know, but it is a powerful image. I think it evokes a lot of emotions, a lot of thoughts about this issue. And whatever that issue might be for you, for some of you, it might be an issue that is a non-issue, and you're upset that the media is kind of blowing up this issue. For others, like myself, it's an issue that's been going on for so long, and it's been ignored by so long, and it really just kind of is just a whole different world if you are a black person, if you're a white person. It's been a serious issue, and it's kind of just blowing it up, and it's being blown up now. But anyway, I really wanted to kind of this picture, I think, really it gets a good rise out of you. You see a lot of I love the fact that they just put the names on there on the tombstones. So, you know, if you know nothing about whatever's happening, you could look up those names and read more about it, and just kind of read on the discourses that happen. You know, right now what's being discussed very frequently are two names, you know, Michael Brown and Eric Garner. The case in Ferguson and the case that just recently happened in New York City. So those are being talked about a lot, but there's so many other names that are kind of similar, but very different too, in a lot of ways. You know, there's names like John Crawford, Tamir Rice, Akai Gurley, Wendell Ellen, Stephen Eugene Washington. You know, all those names on the cartoon. Patrick Dorismond, who died in 2000. You know, that was 14 years ago. But it goes back. You know, there are a lot of names that's been mentioned. You know, 1990 going back to 1980. This is not new. It's not new. That is what's so frustrating. What so kind of builds the outrage. But this system that we live in, this police system, has become more brutal, less able to be held to the standard of accountability. In Los Angeles, there was that video footage of a police officer beating the crap, just punching the face of an elderly black woman. You know, that was caught right on tape. That officer, I don't know how violent that old black lady was. I have no idea what prompted, like, kind of response. Maybe it could be argued that, oh my gosh, this black woman was dangerous and resisting police arrest, so the police officer had to, like, kind of defend himself by putting the lady down. Sure. But the video shows the police officer getting top of that woman and just repeatedly punching the shit out of the woman. I don't, like, that seems to me like excessive use of force by police, and that seems to me to be an example of police brutality. But even that case, I forget the name of the woman, but that case, the police officer was not charged with anything, was not reprimanded in any way whatsoever. So that's kind of the thing. So when I was having my conversation with on the comment section of the Facebook page, I'm very close guy with this friend. So some of what he said really disappointed me, but I didn't want to start up this like back and forth argument with him. So I was like, okay, you know what? I think the best way to do this is kind of just ask you a question. So, you know, I thought he knew a lot about the case. So I didn't want to start on the wrong foot. So, and it's really hard to do on just using words, not in the conversation, like one-on-one personal conversation, that's a whole different picture. But when you're communicating via something like Facebook with words, comments that you type on the word, things can happen. At least we know each other, so we're not anonymous. So that factor is taken out, so that's good. But it was just like, how do I frame this in a way? So I just asked a question. Let's say that, an unarmed black man came to interact with a police officer. And in this interaction, the black man was not rude, obeyed with the police officer's orders, did not resist arrest. But somehow, in this interaction, what ended up happening is the police officer kind of just... The black person ended up dead, you know, because of whatever that interaction happened. And it's clearly the police officer that did this. You know, and I just asked, like, what do you think about that? And it was really interesting, my friend's response. My friend was like, well, if that's the case, you know, if it's the case that the black person was not troublesome, obeyed the orders of the officer, but still ended up dead because, I don't know, the officer, for whatever reason, drew his gun and shot him to death, or in the case of Eric Garner, choked him to death, or something like that. We didn't go into specific, but that was a general question. He said, if that's the case, I mean, then of course the police officer should be reprimanded. He went that route. Well, I was surprised by that. I was like, wait, reprimanded? Whoa. Like, have you not read anything about... I didn't ask him that. But, like, my reaction was like, wait, have you not read anything about what actually happened with all these other cases, like Eric Garner, Michael Brown? Reprimanded? We're not even there yet. We're talking about indictment. We're asking if the police officer should be charged and put into trial. That's it. With reprimanding, we're not... Wow. So, I kind of responded kind of in that matter, like... Well, you know, my thing was, maybe you should, I encourage you to read more and kind of research more about these incidents that has happened. The names on the tombstones in the cartoon, check it out. You know, just read more and kind of get differing opinions. Some people who say this was okay, some people who are outraged, get some differing opinions and then try to think of also that question, what if a black person, you know, interacts with police officer and ends up dead like that. And turns out he didn't really inform about any of these things at all. So now I'm getting all these texts from him, and he's just very shocked. He's like, oh my god, what happened with Eric Garner was just awful. And da 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 da. And I mean, it's amazing. My friend is, I think that's amazing when I can have a conversation with someone, and that conversation actually is genuine. We let each other know, like, okay, this is what I know, this is what I think, and we are able to share our opinions, and we are able to have a conversation without it being like a shouting match of, you're wrong, I'm right. And this is a very controversial issue where it could turn that way. Definitely, you know, and I as an Asian person, who's had, you know, majority of clients that I served in the social services field have been black and Hispanic people. I've just had a lot of interactions with it in the world of, you know, what we call people of color. And Yeah, and my friend is a white man who is in his own environment and something like that. So it can be very volatile, these kind of conversations that can happen. But I'm amazed, you know, that we were able to have a genuine conversation. So it's still possible. It's very difficult sometimes, but I think that's kind of amazing. But that's why I like to really kind of, in some ways, this. And on my Facebook, I don't really have too much posts about this issue. But I did really want to share this cartoon on my Facebook feed, because it's so provocative in a lot of ways. It says a lot of things that I want to say in just that one image. And it gets me to think about this issue in a broader, in a specific way as well. And I just wanted to share with you guys that was one of the conversations I was able to have with a friend. He lives very far away from me, but we used to be really close friends back when I was a high school student, when he was a high school student. But we live so far away from each other, and we haven't really talked to each other that much. We haven't really kept in good touch with each other, which is kind of my fault. So I need to start doing more of that, being more in touch with other people that I know. But yeah, just wanted to share that with you guys. You know, this is a very controversial issue. There are people on opposing sides, on middle grounds, on a lot of opinions, a lot of emotions with this topic. But all kinds of conversations can happen, and I'm actually kind of glad that this discourse is happening around the country in cities. A lot of it is nasty. Yeah. I mean, any conversation involving the word racism, or something that with a hashtag like Black Lives Matter is gonna be controversial, you know, unfortunately. But I'm glad that, you know, conversations are happening, and we're able to kind of, this issue is blowing up, and people are getting out there and being passionate about it. We don't really know what's gonna happen with it, but we're getting out there. We're letting our outrage, just expressing it in the form of a public discourse. And I think that's powerful. So that's really what I wanted to say here in this video, just rambling on. But yeah, hope you guys enjoyed. Feel free to leave comments, questions below in the comment section, whatever your thoughts may be. And I won't get too much into it. But yeah, feel free to do so. Anyway, cheers.